You're listening to the Varsity Sports Show, home of Arizona's youth, high school, college sports, and you, empowering education and enabling dreams right here on KDUS AM 1060 in Arizona. And now, welcome to the Varsity Sports Show.
What's one thing that makes you proud of this group besides like the record and all that football stuff?
Just the adversity we've had to face the last couple of years, you know, losing in the semis on the last play, losing in the state championship play on close to the last play of the game, and then coming back and just being hungry and going, being able to go 10-0 and play with an attitude all year. You know, this is the point we wanted to get back to in the playoffs, and we didn't know it was going to be an open division, but here we are. And Our kids are hungry. They're ready, and I'm really excited and proud to see how they're going to show out on Friday.
Sure. Okay. When was the moment your team faced adversity and you seen them like not shy away but embrace the moment?
In Mesquite game, it was close game at halftime, 20-7, and we came out after that. But the Sunrise game, we were up 20-7 at halftime as well. And then we faced a little bit of adversity, and they powered through that. But I think that Peoria game, you know, we were tied at halftime, and our rival, you know, gave us their best shot. And, you know, we were able to persevere through that with some, you know, some calls that didn't go our way. And they just powered through it, and they just kind of – we have the mantra, Cactus versus Cactus. You know, it doesn't matter who we're playing. As long as Cactus doesn't beat Cactus, we're in good shape.
Sure. I talked to many coaches the same thing. It's like if you don't get in your own way, it's easier for you to win.
Right. Yeah, for sure.
What is the biggest challenge the opposing team presents to your team in this upcoming matchup for you?
Their athleticism, you know, they're in their size up front. They're big, you know, they're talented. They got Division I dudes, and we have really good high school players, you know. Depth-wise, you know, they probably got a little bit more depth than we do, but we feel that if we play our A game, you know, we'll be okay. Our worry is wearing down. You know, we play a lot of two-way guys. So, you know, I think we over-condition to make sure we're in shape for the games like this. So, but they're good. They're well-coached by Coach Mons over there, and it's going to be a big challenge for us.
Sure, because Coach Mons, I believe they're on their streak also, or they've had past success too, just like Cactus. So it's a historical matchup.
Right.
One thing you guys must do to bring home the win this week, like one facet, like tackling, not committing penalties, anything like that.
Yeah, we got to stay disciplined and not have stupid penalties. We also got to play good on defense and stopping the run. Offensively, we got to be balanced with running and passing and taking advantage of the plays that we're going to get. You know, we can't have any drops, can't put the ball on the ground, can't start drives first and 15, first and 20. So we just got to play above the six and play smart.
For sure. Regardless of win or loss, could you speak to how special this group of guys have been this season for you?
Yeah, it's a special group. It's probably the best team I've ever and since I've been coaching since I was 19. So for 16 years, this is the best team I've ever had, not just talent wise, but just as an overall group of kids. We're extremely close, extremely, you know, family tight atmosphere at Cactus. And we just love what they I just told them, I don't want this run to end with this group. So we're going to try and go as long as we can. So we're around them, and every week, you know, we can get closer and, you know, closer and closer together. And that's what has happened. And we're excited to see what the playoffs bring us.
Two more. What does placing in the open division this season mean for like the Cactus program overall?
I think it's huge, you know, to make the open as a 4A school with our enrollment under 1,200, you know, being a top four seed. And, you know, I know Max Preps dropped the top 10 playoffs in the whole country, and it's number seven. So to be in that discussion is really cool. But if we can win a game in the open, I think it's a program changer, you know, getting Cactus on the map, bringing them in here. You know, I think we've kind of already turned into a destination school, but I think we can be the next, you know, Saguaro, Chandler, Hamilton with a win on Friday.
Court. All right, coach. So for Sunrise Mountain, you won championship last year for 5A. You're on the same path this year. Right now, you're heading into the quarterfinals. So how does that feel?
Yeah, it's good. It's good. You know, first of all, it's good to make the playoffs, and then obviously get a win is great. And then moving forward after that, you know, we're just one game at a time.
Mm-hmm. And then, you know, your last win was 30-20, so probably a closer game than you might have anticipated. But what are some adjustments do you think the team would have to make coming into Friday's game?
Just get off to a better start offensively. Like O-line didn't play really well in the first half, then kicked it in the second half. So obviously get a jump start on that and hopefully play four quarters in the entire football game when it comes to line for sure.
Yeah. And, of course, you guys are playing Desert Mountain, one team that you have not faced off this season. I mean, right now it's a 5-4 in the playoffs. So, you know, what does the team have to do to come out with a win on Friday?
They're just well-coached team. That team is. And we're going to just have to, like I said, start off the game really well. Defense is going to have to play really good. They have a lot of weapons on offense, and then, you know, they just get after it on D. So we're going to have to match their intensity for sure. And I know they bring a lot of pressure, so just be ready for that.
Yeah. I mean, that's all the questions I have for you today. Very short. Okay.
And I was curious, what type of emotions kind of come up in a week leading up to a big game like this?
Yeah, I think, you know, right now, whatever, we're so young right now, so our kids are always so high and low as far as emotions are concerned. Sometimes you want them to be a little bit more dialed in. But I think, you know, going into week 12 or 13, as we say, the maturation process for our kids or whatever has continued to elevate each and every week. And so I think, you know, our guys have been rising to the occasion. And, you know, they teeter their emotions a little bit. I think they were a little nervous prior to their first playoff game for a lot of them last week against Ironwood Ridge. But, you know, again, that opponent was good. They played hard against us, their physical team. But I think, you know, as the game wore on, they started to loosen up and get into it. So I think we have one under our belt with these guys, and now we're ready for round two.
And, you know, last week, it was the first game that you guys were held to under 30 points since the Peoria game back in September.
Yeah.
Can you talk about what adjustments were made, if any, to that offensive side of the ball for this week?
You know, I think, you know, we just have to really credit Ironwood Ridge for making big plays in those, you know, critical situations. I mean, last week, you know, we had plenty of opportunities to score 30 or 40 points. We just didn't capitalize on those opportunities. We got stopped on 4th-and-1, I think 3 or 4 times during the game. We missed a couple field goals. And then we got stopped inside the 5 twice, you know, going for it for a touchdown. So, you know, you credit them for some of those things. There was a couple mishaps here and there. They're in a double eagle front. We didn't choke back on the 3 technique, and he ran through on one. They did a good job of stuffing us on the other. We misread the run. Then we missed a couple of field goals, and then we got stopped on 4th-and-1 right around midfield too. So, you know, there was points that were there, and, you know, so we're not going to really change much. We just need to execute better in those situations, be more physical minded. But then, you know, we do credit the opponent for a little bit of our mishaps as well.
And I guess just the final question that I have for you, what was the main message that you gave your players going into this week?
You know, I think, you know, hey, we're playing the state champion from last year. We're playing a team that's tried and true. You know, you look at their schedule, they played 4 teams that played in the open. They beat 4 teams that are ranked in the top 12, I do believe, in the 5A playoff rankings. So they're coming in, you know, tested. And then, you know, of course, you know, they won the state championship last year in 5A. So we know we're playing a very, very quality opponent. And we just have to, you know, each and every week, you know, as you advance in the playoffs, they know that they have to raise their level of play and their execution. Most importantly, you know what I mean, they have to have that intensity. You know, high school or any sports is about execution, of course, but also playing with effort and emotion. Our seniors, they know, man, it's the last play, every play. You know what I mean? You lose and go home now, whatever, you're hanging it up, you know, and there's no more football after tomorrow. So, I mean, you know, I think that they're ready to go.
And then going off of what you just talked about your Thursday morning practice, I saw on your guys' Twitter, you talk about some traditions your team has leading up to playoffs, the Thanksgiving morning practice, and then the Turkey Bowl. Can you talk a little bit about those and what they mean to the team?
Yeah, no, it's, you know, Turkey Bowl is, it's always the night before Thanksgiving, anytime that we're still playing. A lot of the years, it was actually, you know, the week of the state championship game. So it was kind of one of those things, like if you were playing for a state championship, then that's when you got to go bowling. But now with the season being pushed back, it was more for the quarterfinal round. But yeah, we take our team over to the Bolero over on Via Linda. We've done it a bunch, and they just get away and spend some time together, have fun, bowl, and the coaches hang out and play games and just really get away from football, spend time together. And it's always such a great reminder of the what's really special about our program, which it's not winning or scholarships, it's relationships. And I think it just reminds players of how much they enjoy being around each other. And so to take them out, to go do something fun like that, just let them spend time together. It's always kind of, I think, you know, adds a little juice to the program. And then Thanksgiving morning is an awesome tradition. It's, you know, it's typically our walkthrough for the week. Thursdays are always a walkthrough. And so good walkthrough practice. We invite all the parents out of the current players. We invite all of our former players and the parents that have been a part of our program. And the Booster Club, you know, gives them coffee and donuts and hang out. And then at the end, we invite all of our alumni down into the end zone. And we talk about things that we're thankful for. The alumni will share things that they're thankful for and lessons that they learn from the program and kind of impart some wisdom on our current players. Our current players say thank you to the coaches and to their teammates. And it doesn't have to be about football. It could really be about anything. And it's a special moment of a group of guys and girls, our trainers and equipment manager and everybody just kind of opens up. And I think for the young guys really too, it's a powerful moment because you realize you're part of something that's much bigger than yourself. And part of something that's not just for 4 years, but it's for life. And we've got a proud tradition at Saguaro. We've got a lot of great traditions and things that we do, but yeah, Thanksgiving time bowling and that Thanksgiving morning practice, bringing everybody back together is pretty special. And it's things like that allow our program to continue to be great because people, once they experience that, I think they feel a little bit more of the importance of their role on the team other than just, you know, just the X's and O's, but really the tradition that they're carrying on.
And you kind of already answered this, but my last question is going to be, you know, there's 8 teams in the Open Division playoffs, but what do you feel makes your team special and stand out apart from those other 7?
Well, I think we have the best offensive line in the state. I think we have, and we've shown that we have the ability to run the ball against anybody. And I think we have a defense that has shown at times when they're dialed in that we can defend anybody. And we've been good against the run. We've got guys that can cover. And so, you know, when you get into this time of year, if you can run the football and you can stop the run and play good defense, you can beat anybody. And we're battle tested. You know, we've played in a lot of big games over the years. This is our third time in the Open, even though we didn't get to play last year. You know, we've gone toe to toe with Hamilton twice in the last 3 years, gone toe to toe with Chandler and dropped a close game by 7 points. So, you know, I think that's what sets us apart is some of these other teams are very talented teams, but they haven't been there before. They haven't been through the fire, and we've been through the fire. We know what it takes and we're hungry and we wanted to be there. There were some teams that are in it that didn't want to be in it. We're not one of them. We wanted to be in it and not just be in it, but we wanted to win it. And so I think we have the mentality that it takes to make a run because we expect to be there. We expect to win and that's our goal. So we're excited about it. But like you mentioned, they're all the teams are great. And I think anybody is beatable. I don't think there's one team this year that's just head and shoulders above the rest. And so you got to bring your A game every night. And it's going to be a grind and it doesn't get any easier, but if you start looking ahead, you won't be around very long. You got to start with whoever's on your schedule for this week, and they've got to get your full attention. And that's what we've done with Cactus. And then, you know, hopefully we handle business and we'll figure out who we got next. But, you know, we're definitely excited for the challenge.